What's up, everybody? Thank you for coming back to the channel. My name is David Aguilar, or you may know me as Ariel Austin. This last week, I went over to my friend Matt's house, who just started a YouTube channel called Smoke Game Strong, where he goes throughout Texas and tries different foods and barbecues. So if you guys want to check him out, I'll put his channel in the description below. And so we shot a turkey breast on the chud box. So I'm going to show you guys the video and the photos that I took on the Sony a7c with the Tamron 28-200. All right, so I'm currently on my way to my homie Matt's house. Y'all may know him as Come and Smoke It. We're about to do some turkey and eat some really good foods.
What's going down? It's Matt here with Smoke Game Strong. We got another episode of the Smoke Show, baby.
Second segment, and the wind just started blowing like crazy. Look at the clouds. I took these on my phone. It looks insane.
Well, we're out here filming, but I think there might be a tornado coming, so it's lit. We're good to go. I'm gonna turn this close this up so we don't lose the flame.
Now, the reason I love this setup so much is because you have the 28, which allows me to get Matt into frame, and it allows me to just get so much of the area that we're in. But then the 200, being able to zoom it all the way in, allows me to get the peppers and the spices and the juices of the meat and the flames, and you know, get all that cool detail. Now, the only negative side to this lens is just that it's a change in aperture. So it goes from a 2.8 to a 5.6. But again, where the Sony a7C makes up for it is that it's so good in low light that it compensates for the things that we're missing out on when you do zoom it in. Now, this lens is $730, which to me, for what you're getting in the glass quality and just it being a zoom lens and how just small it is, it's pretty light also. And honestly, ever since I bought this lens, I really haven't taken it off the body unless I'm doing something that has to do with real estate photography or something that I need to capture more of a wide angle with. So I'll go to my 17-28. But for this one, when I'm doing street photography and so many other things, I carry it with me because it makes my bag lighter and I don't have to carry as much things with me, which is always good because sometimes you may forget things behind. And when it comes to photography, with these photos that I shot, I just used the natural lighting that was in the room and I shot these photos with it. So if you're someone who's looking to get into food photography or food videography, I think the Sony a7C with the Tamron 28-200 is a great pair. Like I said, your 28 allows you to get your person in frame and you can get their gestures and all that in frame. And at the same time, the 200 allows you to zoom in and get a tighter, closer shot of the food, which when it comes to food photography and food videography, those are the money shots. Those are the things that people love to see. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, remember to like, share, and subscribe, and leave a comment below on other videos you would like to see me talk about, whether it's drone photography, drone videography, whether it is how to get different transitions, maybe even vlogs. All right, until next time, stay safe out there. Until next time, I'm Ron Burton. Until next time, stay jazzy. Hey, keep on trucking. ¿Dónde están mis pantalones? All right, see y'all later, guys. Peace.
You gotta come try a piece of this.
I'm gonna get this piece right here.
Ooh, you want that bark? Mm.
Oh, man.
Oh, shit. This is, it's got a kick,
this
huh?
Kicks.
I think it's that michelada mix. Mm.
definitely. Oh, man. Look at this.
Oh, man.
Look. All right, here. You got to try them off. Look at the dip. Let me get rid of the dip.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Smoke
game. Strong, baby.
All day, every day, baby.
All day.
Mmm.